Note that there's also a slide in your slides that repeats the interpretation of the coefficient beta 1 hat in a simple regression of y on x if either we have taken logs for the y or taken logs for the x or have taken logs for both of them. And it is very common in linear regression that you take a logarithm of some variable, either the dependent or some explanatory variables of both. So here, Aschenfelder and their formula, they took the logarithm of the price index, so the interpretation now of the estimated coefficient in front of the temperature would be that we predict that the vintage's bias index increases by 100 times our estimated coefficient percent if the temperature increases by 1 degree Celsius. So the question is, why do we take the logarithm? So there are different arguments for it. So some are basically thinking about the data generating process and think yourself what is more plausible. So think if we would initially have either a good wine or a bad wine, and now think how would the price increase if it even gets better because of the growing the temperature during growing season goes up by 1 degree Celsius. If we have the price in logarithms, it implies that the absolute temperature increase would increase the good wine by the same percentage in the price and the bad wine, but it means in absolute euros, the good wine increases by even more euros. So if the good wine is worth 1,000 euros and goes up by 10%, it increases by 100 euros. If the bad wine is worth only 100 euros and goes up by 10%, it only goes up by 10 euros. But this kind of seems intuitive, right? You think that buyers of expensive wines probably are also willing to pay a lot extra if they get even a slightly better vintage. I mean, if you really want to have a good wine, then you can afford a good wine, then you're also willing to pay in absolute terms probably more to have the good wine a bit better than having a bad wine a bit better. And this is what you capture, this idea, if you take the logarithm of the price index. And this kind of seems intuitive. But one cannot only make theoretical arguments, one can also look at the data and look which model better fits the observed prices. So where do we have the better predictions? And here I basically plotted for this log level regression, so where the prices have locked and all the other experimentals are not locked. On the x-axis, the logarithm of the actual price, and on the y-axis, the predicted price. So this is prediction of the logarithm price using our estimated coefficients beta 0 hat, beta 1 hat, and setting a 0 for the UT. And this actually looks quite nice. So this blue line is basically a line with intercept 0 and slope 1. And you see that basically the predicted prices are nicely randomly around the actual price. So you don't see any systematic. So basically your prediction error seems to be pretty random. And you also see, it looks like kind of the size of the prediction error, of the residuals here, does not seem to correlate with the absolute value of the price. So this is actually a pretty nice fit. So the prediction errors are nicely randomly around the actual price. Now if you would instead run a level regression, so if you wouldn't take the logarithm of the price, that is what we will see. Here I looked at the price and that's the predicted price. And here you see that this fit is not so nice. In particular, you see for the different problems. For example, for vintages that have a low price, actually our predicted price is negative. Now that's quite unrealistic. Negative price, I mean, you can just put the bottle in the trash before you have to pay a buyer something for it. I mean, there are a few goods where we have negative prices, for example, for electricity in some hours, prices can get negative, but for this wine bottles, it's fairly unrealistic. And also we see that basically here, for the very low bottles with very low prices, our prediction error seems to be substantially more negative. For the bottles with intermediate prices, we tend to have to predict a higher price than the actual price. So here, most of the predictions are above the actual price, while for the bottles with very high price, we predict much lower values. Yeah? For all these three vintages with the highest price, our prediction errors are negative. So we predict a much lower price than the actual price. No? The actual price would be if we continue. Now, if we predicted the actual price, it would have to lie on the blue line and would have to lie somewhere here. And the 61 is far below it. So the graphical analyzer suggests that this log level regression describes the data much better than a level regression.